What's going on, people? I am Kevin Hart, a.k.a. Mr. Comedic Rockstar. This is season two of Cold as Balls. The tub is colder, and my balls are bigger, too. Look, I got two big balls. Oh, what's up, man?
Good.
Odell Beckham is on the show. Put your robe up there. You know how we do, man. Make it do what it does. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. We're gonna get to it, baby. Yeah. Come on now. Get in and sit on the side, huh? Just vibing out. You know how we do. Hey.
Okay.
Go ahead, man, get in. Just, Hey, is my curl in the frame? I don't want that to block me.
Let me see the one on the side, hey? Huh?
Yeah, you know, I got them all over the place.
I'm digging it.
Welcome to another episode of Cold as Balls. I am your host, the Kevin Hart. Odell Beckham Jr. is here on Cold as Balls today. Man, what's up with you, brother?
Chilling, brother.
What's up with you, man?
Man, chilling.
You know, I wanted to embrace a look that you made popular. This is rocking because of you right now.
You doing it too.
Why? Tell me why. What made you go blind and switch it up up top? Was this in LSU when you did this?
Yeah, that's what I was trying to do it, but it was coming out orange. It wasn't as blonde as it is now.
What did you do to get it that blind? Is it peroxide?
No.
I'm from the peroxide days where you throw peroxide in your scalp. I know a couple females that did it, burnt their fucking scalp. Brenda. Shout out to you. Brenda put peroxide on her scalp and there's holes all over the place. Father was Odell Beckham too, I assume, because you're a junior.
Absolutely, senior.
Was father a football player?
At LSU.
LSU?
Mama ran track at LSU.
You come from a family of athletes.
Born for it.
Was LSU a decision based off of where your family went?
It was, and then I lived down the street in New Orleans. My mom and my daddy went there. Born on campus there.
You was born on a campus? Wait a minute now, hold on.
On campus?
God damn, so you had to go there?
Yeah, I had to.
You didn't have a choice. You were there. Your mother's water broke on the campus.
Absolutely.
Without even trying to get signed, you were signed that day.
Committed.
Daryl, did you hear that? Daryl. Daryl, I'm talking to you. He was born on the campus of LSU. Daryl. God damn it, Daryl. We gonna start off like this? Steven Seagal. Well, who the f*** is this? Who in the f*** are you, sir? Daryl, who's this? So now we got Bam Bam Bigelow on the side. Huh? Well, welcome to the goddamn show. All right. Oh, then let's get in the tub. We got stuff to talk about, man. All right, it's a little bit. There. All right, Odell, let's talk football, man.
How come you ain't getting in there?
Well, I'm gonna get it. It just takes me a little longer. That's why I'm the host. Why? Why football? Why did you choose football?
Honestly, football came easiest.
Back up? Excuse the cocky out of me. What do you mean it came easiest?
So, soccer was the first sport I played since I was 3 when I was about 13. I was gonna go join the national team, but you know, growing up, how we grew up, we couldn't just leave the country and go play another sport, so I had to stick with basketball, baseball, and football.
Were you good at soccer?
When I said I was 13, I was going to try for the national team. That's what
in soccer?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Do people know this?
I don't think so.
Well, wait a minute, that's an exclusive. Set off the exclusive lights. Do a graphic. We just did an Odell Beckham exclusive here on Cold as Balls. Who was your favorite soccer player back then?
My favorite soccer player had to be Ronaldinho.
Oh, man. Let me tell you something about Ronaldinho.
Tell me something.
I don't know who he is. Daryl, do you know who Ronaldinho is? Exactly. You're the only black guy that does. You're the only black guy that does know who he is. Now, when you say came easiest, did you just feel like out the gate you were much better than everybody else around you?
In high school, so my sophomore year, I broke my back.
God damn, you broke your back?
Yeah.
So. Bam, bam, you hear that? I know you done broke a couple bats. You know what I'm talking about. Right? Would you say that you became a superstar in Louisiana in general?
In Louisiana, yeah.
I remember when I played low league football, we used to travel to Louisiana. One of the cities where I had, I think it was 9 touchdowns.
What position you played?
This is when I played tail running back, quarterback. I think I threw for 3, ran for 6. And at that point, I was forced with the decision, am I going to follow my football career or do stand-up comedy? And the only reason why I chose stand-up comedy is because I told one of the biggest jokes at halftime. Everybody was like, oh my God, he's got 9 touchdowns. Ooh, how do you do it? And I was like, well, how does a duck quack? Darryl, I told you about that, didn't I? Yeah. Either way, I get what you're saying about the whole football town thing. Now, NFL becomes a reality. Holy shit, how old are you right now when you go to the NFL?
When I went to the NFL, 21.
What is your mentality?
When I was in college, I was like, I want to win a national championship. Made it to the national championship, got blown out. I said I wanted to win a Heisman. Was never close. Said I wanted to be a top 10 pick. Was the 12th pick.
Jesus.
You know, so it was like, nah, it's the only thing I had left. Nah, it's like, I got to win rookie of the year.
Yeah.
I get there, 12th pick in New York. They're doubting me, and I pull my hamstring. Then I'm in church. I'm in church trying to get right. Somebody had the nerve to say, you don't need to be in church. You need to be getting your hamstring right.
You hear that, Bam Bam? What in the... When the f*** did you put that on?
I see you, Darryl.
So I can't have nothing, can I? Boy, we'll just shit on my grave and put me in a goddamn can. Yeah, I'm sorry about that.
So, you know, I get in touch with a doctor of mine, Dr. Dave. He gives me right. Season going on, I'm starting to eat.
By eat, he means he's doing well. That's for my white people that watch the show. When he says, I'm starting to eat, that's slang term for he's doing well. Nah, was the one hand catch born yet?
Wasn't born yet.
Okay.
I'm just starting to chew. I'm putting games after
Stop
games.
Stop right here. Mm-hmm. Chew! Put chew at the bottom of the screen. Chew is another slang term that goes with eat. So he's eating, he's chewing up yards, he's killing, right?
Right, so then Sunday night football happens.
Woo!
Cowboys.
Ooh. How you feel about the Cowboys personally?
I mean.
Darryl, did you see that? You just said, f*** them Cowboys.
Yeah.
Did anybody else see it? I saw it.
So it's Sunday night football, right? I remember. I'm chewing again. So I remember the play, and I'm just seeing the ball in the air, and it's something I've seen hundreds of times. Same spin, same thing I practice. He started grabbing me. I use his momentum, throw him off, catch it with the one hand
catch. The one hand catch was born on Sunday night. You didn't catch that.
It was a bad throw.
All right, now, Eli, what's wrong with his face? Why does he, it's like, what is this? It's the, What is? How do you take that guy serious all the time? Like when he's talking to you, his nose and eyebrows never move. I just want to know what it is.
I don't know what it is.
Do y'all talk about it at practice?
We don't bring it up.
All right, now wait. Before we keep going with the conversation, you gotta sit down in a tub. Give White Hand the bench. Appreciate you. Here it comes. Bam, bam, think fast. Good catch, Bam. Throw it at me one time. Come on. Throw it at me, one hand catch. No, do it. I want to do it how you did it. So throw it back here, let me see it. One more, last one time. Come on, one hand. Oh, yeah. It's a lot harder than it looks. Let me see you do it one time. Here you go. You're in the zone. Oh, underwater in the car. Get under the water. Hey, I'm up. Give me all the weeds. Give me all the weeds. Now I'm cleaning up the tree. Cleaning up the tree. Tree, I'm done. My turn, last one. Ah! Darryl, narrow your mind. Look at me.
Yep, drinking soda. It's nasty. Spit it out. Scratch me, pick my nose. Flick him, eat the booger, and spit it out. Pick a nose, think about it, eat the booger. Why are you eating your boogers every time? That's your signature, you keep going back to that.
I was trying to do something nobody else did. All right, let's get back to the show. Real quick, man, think fast. Celebration dance, go. Stand on the wall, look straight. Hands behind my back,
running. Where am I at? Where am I at? I don't know. Don't recognize this place. It's a scary movie. Here come Jason. He gonna kill me. Don't kill me. Don't kill me, Jason. No. I'm back on the wall. I'm safe.
All right. Enough of the games. I gotta ask you some questions.
All right, brother. Ask away, man.
How much does my haircut cost?
Easy. We go to the same person. I paid $65,000 for mine. Done.
Yeah.
Now, did you ask? Did you ask if I was right or wrong?
Which NBA superstar was my dad's roommate in college?
Okay, this is easy. Wilt Chamberlain.
That's incorrect, brother.
Wait a minute. James Wood. Hey, hey. Think fast, Darryl. He can't catch. Who was he?
Shaq.
Shaq?
Yeah.
Are you serious? I know that room was stinking. Did your dad ever tell you that room was stinking?
Terrible.
I know that room was stinking.
Who's my favorite music artist?
Easy, Selena Gomez.
You were close on that one. Who's Adele?
Oh, Selena Gomez. Who is it?
Drake. Hey, Selena.
What was you feeling when Drake threw you in the song?
You know, listening to him for years, it was crazy to hear. Reach Back Like 1-3, you know that part?
Yeah, he mentioned me in the song.
What did he say?
He said, don't make me break your Kevin Hart, boy. I thought the song sucked.
What you think he should have said?
He should have said something like, you know, I'ma come at you small and mighty, like Kevin, but not like a Kevin Hart, instead, like, I don't know, but that ain't my job. Speaking of music, the celebrations. The NFL making the celebration dance a thing now. I got something for you, brother. I don't need you to do nothing. I'm just gonna give you a dance and you take it. I need a beat, though. Hey, Daryl, Bam Bam, do me a favor, guys. Daryl, Bam Bam, get back there. Guys, when I score a touchdown, give me a beat, okay? Touchdown! Now do the beat. That's what I'm doing, Odell.
What you doing?
Grabbing all the leaves and putting them in the bag.
Okay.
All right. Boom. Ask me what's in my bag.
What's in your bag?
The other team, because I've been eating.
Cleaning up the yard.
Okay, yeah, now that's it. Yeah. Oh, man. So much better than me. Yeah, okay. All right.
My bag's a little heavier than yours.
I get it, Charlie.
Because I was eating.
You didn't tell me you were a goddamn dance champion. I had no idea.
You didn't tell me it was that cold in there.
What the man? You didn't catch a single piece of tape. Got me with the
Down, man. That's enough.
Hi, I'm Kevin Hart. And unless you hate laughter, click and subscribe. And if you do hate laughter, then you're a monster.